Hi everyone, I'm Ibrahim Ulukaya from YouTube API Developer Relations team. And today we will talk about the live streaming API and we will showcase a great integration. It's called RadioLine. Actually, they were one of the first integrators of the YouTube live streaming API. And today we will showcase the API with their with the guys, with the folks from the RadioLine themselves. The CEO of the RadioLine, Thomas Serval, will be joining me today. And we'll actually, and Samuel Landau from as the CTO of RadioLine, and we'll talk about the RadioLine. Hey, Samuel, so, Thomas, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you. Hello, Ibrahim.
Thanks so much for joining us today. And maybe let's talk about what is RadioLine. What's the product itself?
So RadioLine has one goal: is to make radio universally available across the world. And And the first thing we wanted to do is to make sure we were on the number one video site and one of the best websites in the world. So we wanted to be present on YouTube as a first move and as a first product for the company.
And how did you come up with the idea, like, of the right now we know that it's actually RadioLine is creating a digital radio experience on YouTube. And how does the idea came from?
Well, I used to be a YouTuber before, and one of the things that I had to do is to travel a lot, and I'm also a big radio fan. So when I wanted to listen to my favorite radio, I was watching a lot of YouTube channels, but I had to switch to another website, and also I was doing other things while working, and I wanted to listen to my favorite radio. And I suddenly said, you know, this is stupid. Why don't we use YouTube, which is a great search engine, to find out what is going on live on radio and make them available by live streaming? So I started discussing with you guys, and you came up with the API, and they said, okay, now it's becoming possible. So that's how we end up having this idea of making radios available on YouTube.
And that's great. Can you actually show us a little bit of the demo itself, the website and the YouTube channel?
Yeah, so with great pleasure. So it's a beta, so I just want to make sure that we are just available right now in France. And let me share my screen and walk you through the experience we envision. So you have to speak a little bit of French, but I'm going to do the real-time translation. So okay. This is our website right now for French radio. It's called youtube.com/radioline.fr. And there's a little video that explains how it works. I don't know if you can hear the sound, but this is what you can do, is you can listen to any of your favorite radio by searching it inside the YouTube search engine. So for instance, one of my favorite radio could be RTL or Europe 1. And we have categorized all the radio. So for instance, I'm looking for Actuality Means News, or I'm looking for talk radio, or I'm looking for live. So let's go on, I will choose Europe 1, which is a news radio. In live, you can listen to what's going on Europe 1. And you have next to the title of the radio, the metadata, so what's actually on air. And that's actually not so easy. So in real time, we are changing the description of the video so people know what's being aired at every moment. And if you like this radio, then on the right side you have suggestion of other radio or other programs that are live at the same time that you might be interested in listening. So I like news, maybe I want to listen to business news, so I will click on the right side and I will switch to the news in real time. And you see we have the programs that is on the bottom left side with the name and the schedule. So it gives a lot of information to the user so they can navigate between their favorite radio programs. So right now, this is available for 50 French radios, but we are going to extend it to all news, talk, and sports radio across the world in the coming months. I think that's about it at the moment. But we are thinking about adding new feature, and as soon as new features are implemented also in the live API, we can enhance the experience of the radio. So we have a lot of feedback from earlier beta testers about having more information being shown on the screen, and we will automatically show more information about the radio and the programming live.
Yeah, that's great, actually. Maybe actually we can see it a little bit from my own computer and hear the audio and see like one of the channels. So let's
let
go
you,
to the Europe
turn one of the channels.
Chaleur durera jusqu'à vendredi soir. Même si on ne connaîtra pas des minimales aussi chaudes que la semaine dernière, elles sont en hausse. Évidemment,
that's the French weather forecast to tell you that there is a little heat wave around France. So I hope you want to visit this part of the country.
So yeah, that was like the one of the streams over there. Yeah, maybe it's a good time to actually go deep dive a little bit about the API integrations. Because besides, since you're already doing the live streaming, using the live streaming platform for this, also you are one of the first integrators of the API. Maybe at this time, Samuel, the CTO of the RadioLine, can join me and can help explain about how the integration went so far and what are the other expectations on the API itself. So, Samuel, how was your app implemented? Can you talk a little bit?
I sent you a diagram, maybe you can show it. So basically we have implemented connectors from our RadioLine service that use the radio audio streams to encode the video stream that we send to YouTube live stream. And on the other hand, we have made an automaton that regularly updates the metadata for the YouTube live broadcast.
I see. So actually, as well as you're like live streaming to YouTube, you're also updating with your metadata all the time with your app, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
So the RadioLine service platform is providing this metadata. And so we just had to make a program which is both a client from RadioLine and a client to YouTube Live APIs, and also encode this video with information including metadata and the audio radio stream. So we had to do a quick and dirty implementation. So we first made a PHP implementation, so actually that's a web service, and our next implementation will be a Python Django server with some back office functionalities added.
And was there anything like surprising while you were using the API itself, because you already actually you started really early testing the API even before the other users?
Yes. So we had a lot of surprises. I was surprised by the swiftness of API updates on YouTube behalf. One day we were requesting some new parameter functionality, and the day after or 2 days after, it was available, so I was impressed. Also, what surprised us a lot was the fast indexing of the live broadcast. Actually, the live broadcasts have this 24-hour limitation, so we have to recreate them every day since our radios are 24/7. So every day we recreate the live broadcast, and we did not expect for this live broadcast to be indexed so quickly in the YouTube engine.
I see. And for like a counterintuitive thing, you actually mentioned about the 24-hour limitation, right? You actually had to create your own, I think, refresher for that?
Yes, yeah. We had to to make a kind of back office that automates this live broadcast recreation to overcome the limitation. Well, we understand that most live events are short-lived, but for our needs, our specific needs as a RadioLine service, we need it 24/7. Radios do not stop streaming.
Yeah. I think you also ask it as a feature, and we hope like we may get there. And have you actually tried the other APIs like data API, and have you ever used the other APIs on top of the live streaming?
Yes, actually. Thomas mentioned the channel and the playlist. We automated their management, so we are using the data API V3, actually.
And can you guys a little bit more on the feedback side or the other features you want to see in the live streaming API, or could be data API or other APIs as well?
So we plan on adding some back office functionality so that we can offer a service to radios in the streams. So we will need a richer live queue calls. Today it's a bit limited. For live radios, the description includes the program of the radio, so we would very much like to have a description that updates in the user screen. Today they are static. We think it would be nice to have annotations like in the YouTube service. We understand that for a live event it has many new constraints, but we think it would be very nice.
Okay, great. Maybe this time I can go back to my own screen and a little bit summarize actually what they were doing as RadioLine. As you know, there is the live streaming, YouTube as the live streaming platform. And we also made available the API itself. So by using the live streaming the platform, they are actually streaming all these videos. They are sending to YouTube, and actually those videos are available as a live streaming. And at the same time, what they did is they actually used the API to create those events rather than creating them again and again. They actually used like an automation tool, which they actually create all this using the API. They set the streams, they were able to update all the metadata on top of them, and they used it as creating the new events, or rather refreshing the events, and they used the API from that side. And I guess that was like the most of the talk, and maybe I can just show like few other radios that are available from the RadioLine. And as you guys see, they actually have like few, not only one stream, they actually have few streams going on at the same time. All the radios are available through the channel, which they created like multiple events in their on their own YouTube channel. And saying that, I guess that was the most of the RadioLine and how they use the YouTube live streaming API. Thanks so much for joining me guys today. And it was really
Thank
nice to have
much.
You guys. And I know it was like quite like also challenging while you guys trying to be a tester development and went so far to create like an amazing platform on top of the YouTube live streaming.
Thank you very much.
Thank
also
you
for your help. Thank you.
Thanks a lot. And before finishing, as you guys know, we are always hiring almost everywhere around the world as a YouTube developer relations team. Just go to developer.google.com/jobs, and you will see all of the open positions. And thanks a lot for joining me, guys. Ibrahim Ulukaya from New York. Thanks.
Bye.